Thanks very much indeed, Eric. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A great pleasure to be here to announce the winner of the 2017 Wellington Community Trust Lifetime Contribution to Sport Award. Now, before we announce the winner, please welcome the Chair of the Wellington Community Trust, Geraldine Clifford-Lidstone, to say a few words about their involvement and then to stay on and present the award. Geraldine.
During the Sports Awards last year, I was asked by someone why the Wellington Community Trust sponsors this award when there are so little parallels between the Lifetime Contribution to Sport Award and what we do at the Community Trust. And I said, well, what do you mean? And they said, well, not to state the obvious, but the recipient of this award is usually someone well known in the sports sector and no one knows what you do. I thought that was a bit rough. But this award is not about how well known you are. It is about over 20 years of demonstrated service and loyalty to the Wellington region. It's about committing your time, achieving high levels of success, making a significant impact, and your contribution to the development of local talent. The Wellington Community Trust are honoured to sponsor this award because even though no one knows who we are, except maybe for the 170 Wellington organisations that we've funded, with grants of between $1,000 and $200,000 in the last year, the criteria for this award is what we want organisations we fund to do for the wider Wellington region. Like the recipient of tonight's award, we hope to look back and through our support know that we've made a positive difference to our Wellington community. We congratulate tonight's recipients and all winners. Whawhite lava.
Thanks, Geraldine. This year's recipient first played basketball in his final year at Wellington College in 1973. And in the 44 years since, he's made an almost immeasurable contribution to basketball in our region. He played in the former Central League and the Wellington Basketball League and was first elected onto the Wellington Basketball Association executive in 1994. 1 year later, he became president, a position he held for 10 years, supporting them financially when they were facing insolvency. He continued to support the Wellington Basketball Association over many years, sponsoring court hire, apparel purchase, tournament operation, and countless other things. In 1998, fire destroyed Wellington Basketball's headquarters at Newtown Stadium. So began a campaign to establish a large indoor sports facility here in the capital. The result is the magnificent ASB Sports Centre. Tonight's recipient attended every Wellington City Council planning meeting, council committee meeting, community consultation meeting, and council election meeting in Wellington South. He met with the mayor, city councillors, council officers, Sport Wellington, and representatives of other sports. He negotiated on key elements of the process to ensure the stadium was included in the council's long-term plan. He went to Melbourne to analyse the Albert Park Stadium complex. He found out who the proposed architects of the Wellington Centre were, obtained from FIBA the vast amount of information they had on stadium construction fit-out, and then went to see the architects with post-it notes on the relevant pages. The result is a high-quality floor and equipment fit-out, wide margins between the courts, and a stadium constructed on the priority principles of natural light and air movement. His conviction to the plan also ensured the number of courts, originally planned at 8, was increased to 12. Construction began in 2010, and the ASB Sports Centre opened in 2011. All this time, he continued to serve on the Wellington Basketball Association's Executive Committee from 2005 to 2012. In 2002, he joined the Board of Basketball New Zealand and was Vice President from 2003 to 2006. He drafted a new constitution for the organisation and campaigned successfully for the return of the NBL as part of Basketball New Zealand. He was also the Basketball New Zealand representative on the International Basketball Federation's Oceania Board. For 30 years, he has been a monumental supporter of the Wellington Saints. He's been chairman, treasurer, is still an active board member, and never misses a home game. He was also a member of the NBL board as a player representative for 5 years. He was instrumental in the formation of the Capital Zone Basketball Trust, basketball's new regional sports organisation for the Greater Wellington region, and has again been generous with his time, his legal advice, and his financial support. And as a member of this trust, his focus is on the young people in our region. He wants to ensure all children have the opportunity to play basketball regardless of where they live or how much money they have. He's made significant financial donations, assisting many players who have made New Zealand representative teams, paying for their travel to ensure they don't miss out on any opportunities because of their financial background. He's also paid international airfares for players who receive scholarships and made substantial donations to various basketball organisations in the region to ensure their sustainability. And these generous acts aren't all in the past tense. He continues to give annual contributions to schools in low decile areas, allowing children to have shoes and transportation to games and practices. And his generosity isn't just financial. He's helped local, regional, and national organisations in legal and constitutional matters with historical facts and simply as an expert on basketball issues. Saints owner Nick Mills says he is the most intelligent man he has ever met. And Nick Mills has met a lot of people. The man we're honouring is a workaholic and famously came to work every Sunday in bare feet. He's a member of the New Zealand Order of Merit for services to basketball, was awarded the Sir Lance Cross Memorial Award by Basketball New Zealand, and is a life member of Basketball New Zealand and the Wellington Basketball Association. In mid-2014, he was diagnosed with motor neuron disease. Upon further investigation, it became apparent he'd had MND for 18 months. At that time, a specialist estimated his life expectancy at 2.5 years. That was 3.5 years ago. It seems he wasn't particularly interested in that prognosis. Last August, he was told he probably wouldn't see the end of the year, and yet here we are in June, and this is not a eulogy. It is a tribute to someone who is still very much alive and kicking, a man who for the last 4 decades has given and continues to give absolutely phenomenal support to basketball in our region. His dedication and patronage are utterly selfless and simply beyond exceptional. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to announce that the recipient of the 2017 Wellington Community Trust Lifetime Contribution to Sport Award is Justin Toebes.
So tonight's a special night where we celebrate someone who's given so much to Wellington basketball. I stand here on behalf of the Wellington Saints 2017 and would like to send a huge thank you to Justin. So tonight's about you. You've done so much for the Saints over the years, over the many, many years that you've been involved with the Saints. And although you're someone that doesn't really want to be acknowledged or want any gratitude for your goodwill, you've done so much for not only the club, but for a lot of people here in the Wellington basketball community. So tonight, Justin, on behalf of the Saints once again, we thank you and enjoy the rest of the evening.
Congratulations, Justin!
Justin, lovely to see you, mate. What has been at the heart of your 4+ decades of involvement and dedication to basketball?
Well, I was useless as a player, but a senior referee once told me I'd be a much better administrator than player, and he was absolutely right. And what I really loved about it was the values of sport, particularly basketball. It was, in basketball, everyone has to play offense and defense. Everyone has to come off the court, sit on the bench. Everyone has to have individual skill and participate in the team effort. And the most important thing at the end that I could see coming out of participating in sport, and in particular my exciting sport, basketball, was self-respect. And that's why I've got involved in administration over many years. I could see everyone who participated, everyone who got into the game, enjoyed it, but they got that self-respect, and that was just phenomenal.
You've obviously helped a great number of people, a huge number of people. What about the people who have helped you? Anybody you'd like to thank tonight?
Nick Wells has been fantastic. We went Fran with the Wellington Saints. Just an amazing organisation. So clever, ambitious, and such a good group of people. Absolutely amazing. Bill Eldred, who worked for Wellington Basketball Association for many, many years, was a mentor, was a coach, was a co-player, and was a referee who fouled me out regularly.
Brilliant, and we could chat all night, I'm sure, but any words that you'd like to say before we get you down for a photo and some more slaps on the back and celebrations?
No, it's fantastic. It's, as I said, you get self-respect from participating in sport, but this is the respect from the community, and that's absolutely amazing. Thank you very much, and also to the Community Trust.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Wellington Community Trust Lifetime Contribution to Sport Award winner for 2017, Justin Toebes.